And the other big political story of the last 24 hours is from Kansas. The U.S. Senate race there grew much more interesting late yesterday after Democratic candidate Chad Taylor abruptly announced that he was dropping out of the race. That leaves independent Greg Orman to face off against veteran Republican incumbent Pat Roberts, who just last month survived a Tea Party primary challenge. And all of it could have far-reaching consequences for which party controls the Senate. For more, I spoke just a short while ago to Jonathan Martin. He is the national political correspondent for the New York Times. Jonathan Martin, thank you for joining us at the NewsHour again. So why did this Democratic candidate, Chad Taylor, suddenly pull out 2 months before the election?
Well, because quietly there has been pressure on him to get out because there is a well-funded independent candidate who Democrats think may actually have a shot to beat Senator Roberts this fall. Pat Roberts is someone who's never really had a race, Judy. He's been in Washington since 1980 when he first came to the House, came to the Senate in 1996. He's never received below 60%. Why is it different now? Well, because he is somebody who has been attacked from the right for the entire year. He had a tough primary against a Tea Party opponent, and he's made a few gaffes on the campaign trail that are connected to the fact that he does not have a home of his own in Kansas anymore. His primary home is in Alexandria, Virginia, in the Washington suburbs. And so he is somebody who was vulnerable to a primary challenge. He won his primary, Judy, in August, but only got 48% of the vote. There was some polling in the weeks after that that showed this third-party candidate, who again has been on TV because he has money, was competitive with Roberts, and Democrats believe that if their own nominee was to get off the ballot and they could make the independent the de facto Democratic nominee, they would have a shot to pull off one of the biggest upsets in Senate history and beat Pat Roberts in Kansas, a state which has not sent a Democrat to the U.S. Senate, Judy, since 1932.
It would be historic by political standards. The Republicans, though, are saying that Chad Taylor, the Democrat, that there's some corruption involved, that there's something that may even need to be investigated.
Right.
What do we know about that?
Well, the big news today, Judy, is that the Secretary of State in Kansas, who's a Republican, Chris Kobach, who oversees election law, is actually saying that Mr. Taylor, the Democrat, can't come off the ballot because the Kansas law indicates that you can only do so if you have shown the inability to perform the duties of office. And the Secretary of State Kobach is saying that Mr. Taylor has done no such thing, that he would, in fact, be capable to serve, and so he can't come off the ballot. So that brings the question up. Is the Democrat himself going to be actually on the ballot? And keep in mind, they have to print the ballot pretty soon because they have to start issuing absentee ballots for overseas voters. So we may see some litigation here in the days ahead. And even if we don't, you could have a Democrat still on the ballot, Judy, who is a non-candidate, who is not campaigning anymore, who is basically saying, don't vote for me. It's quite a remarkable scenario.
But the upshot is that Senator Roberts, the veteran Republican lawmaker, may be vulnerable now. This independent candidate, Greg Orman, how would he vote? He says he's independent.
Right.
Would he vote Democratic if he were elected? Is it known? What are his positions on the issues?
Well, his politics seem to be mostly sort of centrist politics. His consultants, Judy, are Democratic consultants. He's obviously somebody who Democrats think could caucus with them next year if he does win. Keep in mind, there are two independents currently in the Senate, both of which caucus with Democrats.
Right.
And the expectation would be that he, in fact, would cast his first vote to make Harry Reid leader and would caucus with the Democrats. That is the key vote, the first vote. Will he support Harry Reid for leader? And that's what Democrats care about when it comes to Mr. Orman.
But overall, this is a huge headache for Republicans, I hear you saying. They want very much to become the majority in the Senate, and this makes it harder.
They're on the doorstep of retaking the Senate. They need six seats. Three of them are probably in the bag. And now they have a complication here because in a year where they're mostly on offense, the Republicans are, they now have to play defense in the most unlikely of states, Kansas, which, again, has not had a Democrat in the Senate since the Hoover era.
Well, it's a story that we are going to be watching. Another 2 months to go. Jonathan Martin in the New York Times, we thank you.
Thank you, Judy.